What we eat has a significant impact on the hormonal balance of testosterone and estrogen in our bodies. More than any other food, soy has long been vilified as a testosterone-crushing, estrogen-enhancing food, often cited by men as a reason to not go vegan. Beer, on the other hand, is stereotypically associated with manliness and virility, liquid testosterone even, if we're to believe some commercials. But outside of internet hype and advertiser hyperbole, what's the true hormonal impact of what we put in our bodies? Hi, it's Emily from BiteSize Vegan, and welcome to another vegan nugget. It's no secret that what we eat affects our health, though you'd never know that from speaking with the vast majority of medical doctors. I cannot even count the number of times I've heard from men that they can't go vegan because of the estrogenic effects of soy, with the most often offered concern eloquently stated in the pejorative, man boobs. In this third installment of the Men's Health series with Dr. Michael Greger of NutritionFacts.org, we'll get to the bottom of the soy controversy and see what foods and beverages are the most beneficial or detrimental to testosterone levels. For more in-depth information on testosterone and diet, as well as what to eat and avoid for erectile dysfunction, be sure to check out the first two videos in the series. Now let's hear what Dr. Greger has to say about the hormonal impact of diet. So soy remains a highly controversial food, with many men are concerned about its estrogen-promoting components. It's often even used as a reason for men not to transition to a plant-based diet. So what is the actual hormonal effect of soy on men?
1951 Australia. That's where it all starts, where we have two Australian chemists who are tasked with trying to solve the mystery of why sheep in Australia were becoming infertile, devastating the wool industry in Australia. These two chemists discovered that it was the clover, that there was clover that had a phytoestrogen called genistein, the same phytoestrogen that's found in soy, and it had these estrogenic effects and was affecting the fertility of the sheep. And so if you go online, you read about the dangers of soy, you'll see the dreaded clover disease, lots of allusions to the dreaded clover disease, but you'll notice what they don't talk about is the dosing. To get as much of this phytoestrogen in your body as the sheep were in clover, one would have to drink, one would have to eat 8,000 soy burgers a day, or 800 pounds of tofu, or 1,000 cartons of soy milk a day. And only then would you get the same kind of effects that these poor sheep were getting. Now, this is not to say you cannot overdo it. There have been two case reports in the literature of feminizing effects in men eating as few as like 14 to 25 servings of soy a day. All right? So, but at any reasonable amount of soy intake, so these are men drinking gallons of soy milk a day. So, but if you stick to less than 14 servings a day of soy, no feminizing effects ever reported, and in fact have beneficial effects for prostate health, et cetera, et cetera.
So what foods are best to balance or enhance male hormonal levels?
Well, so it would be a plant-based diet, as I talked about before, avoiding beer, actually. It's interesting. The most potent phytoestrogen in the world is not in soy. It's in beer. So these German scientists saw this work in Australia and said, aha, that's why female hop pickers start menstruating as soon as they start touching hops. And that's because of this powerful estrogenic effects of hopien, which is the phytoestrogen found in the bittering agent in beer. And indeed, women who drink beer actually have stronger bones, less hot flashes, etc. And that's because of this phytoestrogenic effect. Unfortunately, the phytoestrogen in beer attaches preferentially to alpha estrogen receptors as opposed to beta estrogen receptors, increasing the risk of breast cancer. So the reason that you see hop extracts in so-called breast enhancement supplements is because of that phytoestrogenic effect, whereas soy phytoestrogens attach preferentially to beta receptors, unlike your own estrogens, your own endogenous estrogens, and so actually have a breast cancer reducing effect, though the same protective effects in terms of hot flashes. And alcohol itself can decrease testosterone levels, but beer in particular. So I'd encourage people to, if they're worried about testosterone, they shouldn't be chugging a six-pack.
It is kind of interesting how we have the stereotype that to be the manliest you can possibly be, you need to be consuming a bunch of meat and drinking a lot of beer. And it sounds like from what we've covered, that's the worst thing you can do for virility and sexual performance.
And lifespan.
I hope you enjoyed hearing from Dr. Greger on the estrogenic effects of soy and, surprisingly, beer. The hormonal impact of what we eat reaches far beyond fears of feminization, as we saw with the cancer-promoting effects of hops and cancer-reducing effects of soy. Regardless of gender, the hormones in what we consume can have life-altering and life-ending consequences. While it is incredibly important for us to track our own nutrition to make sure we're getting what our bodies need, I know that doing so can be a huge pain. So I wanted to let you know about Chronometer. It's a free website and app that I've used in several of my videos because of its uniquely detailed nutrition reports and ease of use. Plus, Chronometer was awesome enough to sponsor the Dr. Greger Nutrition Series and have come on board for the remainder of the Men's Health Series as well. Be sure to click the link in the description to make your own free profile. It's not an affiliate link, so I'm not getting money when you click on it, but it will let Chronometer know that BiteSize Vegan sent you. You can also find links to relevant studies and Dr. Greger's site on the blog post for this video linked in the description below. Please share this video around to help men take hold of their health. Be sure to subscribe to the channel to not miss out on the rest of the Men's Health series. To support free education like this, please see the support links below or click the Nugget Army icon or the link in the sidebar. Now go live vegan, give soy a break, and I'll see you soon. Is alcohol vegan? Well, first of all, don't be so obtuse. Alcohol is quite a broad term now, isn't it? You see, fine wine differs greatly from something as base as liquor or, God forbid, beer. You must be more precise with your inquiries if you want to receive more accurate responses. Is alcohol vegan? Ain't no animals in there. Nope. I think you're good. You got a pretty mouth.